Hello everyone. Today I want to talk about a very important topic, which is what are the do's and don'ts or what are the important care tips that we should keep in mind with our house plants. Now, we all love house plants. They add a lot of beauty, a lot of aesthetic value to our homes, and they just completely revamp the interior. For me especially, they bring in a lot of positivity, because a plant is a living thing, and obviously it adds a lot of life, a lot of light, and a lot of positivity. Now, if we talk about the scientific aspect of it, that plants, they definitely purify the air, and some of these house plants are so amazing that they remove the toxics like formaldehyde from the air, and they purify our homes. So let's talk about number one, which is their grooming. Now let's look at this one over here, this money plant. Yeah, so you can see that the plant is pretty lush and green. It's actually money plant golden, and there are some old leaves over here. So obviously, in a house plant, you should not let any dead leaves hanging. So I have a scissor over here, and I'm gonna cut this, because first of all, it doesn't look nice, and secondly, what happens is that when dry leaves and all are there, there is a possibility that eventually when it will start decomposing somewhere around here, it might give fungus a chance to breed. So it is better that we remove such things. So I'm going to remove it. So yes, I have removed the dead leaves from the plant, and this money plant, actually I started growing it from the cuttings that I actually propagated through a water propagation method. You can see that video in my from my previous videos. You can have a look at it. So now the plant has finally started growing. These are the new leaves. This very beautiful variegation you can see. So yes, point number one is to remove all the dead leaves which are there. Now, next thing, see, some of our plants, the potting mix. So when we have to plant any indoor plant, we have to see that in which kind of media we are going to place the plant into. So this one is actually in sand mixture, in sand, garden soil, and some vermicompost. So I planted it in that. But this one, this snake plant, I had made a video on it. I had bought it from Amazon. I'll take it out and I'll show it to you all. Yeah, so yes, here is the plant. Yeah, so this is actually growing in coco peat. So coco peat, as we all know, that it holds on to a lot of moisture. Yeah, so what happens is, when a plant is planted into coco peat, definitely you don't need to water it more frequently. So if you are someone who's very busy, who cannot keep track of time, who forgets when you're supposed to water and all, and sometimes the plants, they start drying up and all, so it's better for someone like you. I think you should plant your indoor plants into coco peat, because if you do that, your plant is going to stay healthier, it is going to stay moist, and it's not going to dry up, because it will hold water for a very long period of time. So we also need to see that what kind of potting mix is going to be perfect for this plant. Also, because we place them indoors, it's not very hot on the inside indoors, and the environment is not very dry or drying up, so obviously the water is going to be there. It's not gonna dry as fast as it does when the plant is kept outdoors. So I think it's a good practice to either plant your all your indoor plants into cocopeat, or you make a nice healthy very porous mixture using garden soil, sand and some vermicompost, so that the plant is healthy and is not waterlogged, it's not sitting in water. Now the third thing that I'm going to talk about is keeping the leaves clean. Now I have already cleaned the leaves of my rubber plant, so I'm going to talk about my ZZ over here. I was just you know, cleaning the leaves and all, and I thought that, you know, why not make a video and share it with you all. So this is already clean. So let's talk about ZZ plant. So now ZZ plant is a very unique plant that it just has leaves, and you know, it's a petiole, and it doesn't have, like, you know, a stem and then some leaves. It's just, you know, like a stem is, or a shoot, and it has leaves. So it's one of my favorite plants. I love it. So what happens is, it's very important for us to keep the leaves of the plant healthy, because the plants, they make their food, they do photosynthesis through their leaves. So it's important for us that we remove any dust which is accumulated on the leaves. So what you can do is, so even this ZZ plant is potted in cocopeat, and you can see that it's very dry. See, it's absolutely dry. But I'm pretty sure that if I stick my finger deep into it, there is going to be some moisture. Yes, I can feel some moisture, but even if I water it now, it's not gonna cause any damage, because the ZZ actually holds a lot of water into its this thick fleshy stem. And also, can you see this rhizome? So even this rhizome holds a lot of water. So we need to identify that, you know, what kind of plants can do well in cocopeat or in sand, can do in less water, and as per that we can place them into a suitable potting mix. So you can see that there is some dust, there's actually a lot of dust on the leaves, and the leaves are not looking, you know, they are dirty. So you have to remove all the dirt which is placed onto the leaves, so that the plant is able to make food, to do photosynthesis properly, is able to do transpiration properly. So we must clean the leaves time to time. Now I had made a video when I bought this ZZ plant, and at that time it had like some 5-6 shoots. But the most interesting thing is that in this course of 1.5 month, or maybe a month, 3 or 4 new shoots have come out. This is a new shoot, you can see. This light green one is a new shoot. This is a new shoot, and there is another one which is hidden somewhere here. So this is a new shoot. So 4 new shoots have come out in this course of 1 month that I got it home. I'd like to add that I did not disturb the plant at all. I kept it in a well-lit spot, and I water it whenever, you know, I see that, you know, now the cocopeat is entirely, like, I stick my entire finger inside and I check that now it's entirely dry, so I can water it. Please don't overwater it, otherwise the leaves will start turning yellow and the plant will start burning up. So please don't do this mistake. It's a very hardy plant. If you want me to make a video on the ZZ plant, I'll be very happy to do so. And lastly, yes, this spider plant. So this was actually attacked twice by insects, and I managed to save it. You can see that you know, the leaves are eaten up, and even this one, it has got some, you know, even this one is eaten up. So it was attacked by insects, and they just, you know, you give them like 3-4 days and the plant, you know, it's going to, all its leaves and everything is going to be cut, and it will be, you know, it will be very badly damaged and affected by the insects. So we have to make sure that regularly we spray our house plants with some you know, insecticide or fungicide or something. So I have made a video, the fungicide or insecticide that I make at home, using neem oil, some liquid soap or liquid detergent and water. So we have to regularly spray our plants to keep them healthy. My rose was attacked, then croton was attacked. Croton was attacked twice. So that process is going on. I also sprayed it on my other plants, gardenia and all. Even gardenia, there is something wrong with it. So I am trying to, you know, figure out and take care of it. So we have to, you know, we can't have this attitude that, you know, these are simple plants or these are not flowering plants, so they will not be attacked by pests and insects and fungus. No, it's not true. Any plant, they are vulnerable to diseases. They have different sort of diseases that can affect them. So we have to keep it in mind that regularly, I think once or twice in 2 months, we should make a simple solution using neem oil, liquid soap, and spray all our plants using that mixture so that no insect or disease is affecting the plant. And lastly, fertilizing. Though these are non-flowering plants, but for a healthy growth, we do need to give them that extra nourishment and nutrient and supplements. So for that, what I do, I take a 1 teaspoon of NPK. I mix it in like 3 liters of water, and then I give it to my plants once in 1.5 month or 1 month or 2 months. I don't keep a record, but yeah, I try to feed them. Or you can do, if you don't have NPK, just take the plant, put some 1-2 teaspoons of vermicompost and mix it, you know, till the topsoil using a spoon or a fork, if you don't have gardening tools. And you can put 2-3 spoons of vermicompost so that the plant gets nourishment of and a mixture of both micro and macronutrients. So you should do that. Let's not ignore our house plants. They are very forgiving, gentle, delicate, and they have, you know, some requirements. So we should definitely not neglect them, that only flowering plants can get attacked or they need a lot of fertilizers and all plants require. And this is just a very, you know, a small example that something so small can eventually start turning something so beautiful, provided we take care of it. Lately, I've collected a lot of money plants. If you want me to make a video on it, and syngoniums also, so I will be very happy to make one for you. You can follow me on Instagram. My Instagram handle is suhasini_lives_sattvic. You know, I'm very active there. You have any doubts, queries, you can always contact me over there for a very quick response, or comment in the comment section below, and I make sure that I never miss a comment, and I help each one of you with whatever knowledge I have. So that's all for today. Happy gardening. Thank you so much. Bye.